On the eve of his birthday, Energy Secretary Jericho Petilla confirms he's stepping down from his post. But Petilla denies his decision to leave has anything to do with the looming power crisis in the country. Alvin El Chico reports.
Yes, nag-resign ako at hinanin ko yung resignation ko before the Holy Week.
With this, Energy Secretary Jericho Petilla confirmed his resignation. He said he had already put in place vital measures to avert a power crisis in Luzon and Visayas. Petilla added, for the past 2 years, he had already been telling the president of his intention to quit government service.
The only thing we can do right now is actually monitor the power situation. Lahat ng pwedeng gawin na gawa na. And basically, it looks like, based on our outlook, we're really going to survive 2015.
Petilla clarifies he harbors no grudge against the president, nor did he tangle with any cabinet member on policy issues that may have pushed him to resign.
Kusa akong naghanin ng resignation. Wala pong nag-influensya sa atin dito. Walang nagtulak. Walang nag-pressure. Okay. It really came from me.
Petilla admits he may go back to politics after serving the cabinet, but whether he's running for the Senate or seeking a local or provincial position, the outgoing secretary says he's keeping his options open. It appears, though, that Petilla will stay a little longer at the DOE. President Aquino announced in Malaysia that Malacanang is still looking for a suitable replacement for Petilla.
Secretary Petilla will not leave the job na hindi siya sure that it is in capable hands or that everything is already in place that has to be attended to as Secretary of Energy.
Ako'y mag-iintay na lang na instruction sa kanya at pag-uusapan namin how to move forward.
Petilla was governor of Leyte when he was appointed DOE Secretary in 2012. He recommended the granting of additional powers for President Aquino to enable government to generate additional electricity source in order to avert potential rotating power interruptions this summer. But even if Congress failed to pass the joint resolution, Luzon and Visayas still have enough reserve electricity. On his 52nd birthday Wednesday, Petilla will celebrate by thanking DOE employees who have worked with him for more than 2 years. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.